People admire and emulate those who live in accord with what they say. How can we put our beliefs into action? 1 Peter teaches believers that they must live holy lives and do good, loving deeds for others, thus demonstrating that they trust in God and have been born anew. Writing from Rome, referred to as Babylon in the text, Peter pens this epistle to the dispersion, using language often associated with the Jewish diaspora, to describe the state of early Christianity, where Jewish and Gentile Christians are spread throughout the Roman Empire. In the midst of the difficulty of everyday persecution, Peter offers encouragement, affirming that Christ's church lives in the world of the already and the not yet, where the kingdom of God has broken into the world but has not been fully realized. And that brings us to our key verse for today, which reads, "So you must live as God's obedient children. Don't slip back into your old ways of living to satisfy your own desires. You didn't know any better then, but now you must be holy in everything you do, just as God who chose you is holy." 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 14 and 15. Peter exhorts believers to refrain from a life pattern after their former ignorance of God. Instead, they are to pattern their lives after the one who called them, God the Father, who is holy. Thus, in every aspect of their lives, they are to seek to be holy as well. Believers are called to imitate God and His holiness by living lives marked by holiness in every sphere. The Apostle Peter roots this exhortation in Scripture. God, who called the people of Israel to be His own special people, gave them this charge: "You shall be holy, for I, the Lord your God, am holy." Believers are children of God, but this familial relationship with God, while giving us a sense of belonging, should not cause us to be presumptuous. Our status as His children does not give us an excuse to live recklessly. Just because we are His children does not mean that He will overlook our disobedience. Though believers will not miss eternity because of their sin, we must certainly expect the Lord's discipline in this life when our behavior is contrary to His will. God is the judge of all the earth, and our Father as well, and as such should command our deepest respect. Deep respect for God should be coupled with a deep sense of gratitude and awe at the costliness of redemption. No silver or gold redeemed us from our past life of sin. God rescued them from the sinful traditions, beliefs, values, and behavior inherited from their ancestors through the precious blood of Christ. Christ's sacrifice, His death, was no accident. Rather, events had already transpired, and Christ was foreordained to be our Savior. God planned our redemption from the foundation of the world and carried it out in Christ. In the course of human history, Christ was revealed. He came into the world for our salvation. This was all the plan of God. Through Christ alone has every believer's faith in God been established. Peter's readers are considered sincere believers. They are a people who have been purified by obeying the truth of the gospel and responding to it in faith. The imagery of purification is from the Old Testament ceremonial washings, which the priests and Levites serving in the temple were commanded to do. They are a people who experience the renewal of the gospel, a fact manifested by their sincere love for their fellow believers. Now they are encouraged to deepen that love for one another. Purifying their souls has also given them pure hearts, which they ought to love each other. This is what demonstrates that the renewing power of the gospel is at work in our lives, our continued pursuit to love one another as God in Christ has loved us. Here's our lesson. The holiness of conduct is not reducible to mere one-on-one relationships and includes these, but as technology continues to develop, our webs of influence tend to grow. As these webs of influence grow, our conception of our neighbor must grow as well. As our understanding of who our neighbor is grows, our understanding of how to love our neighbor has to change with it. Thus, holiness has to be the framework within which we consider our decisions, such as where to live, where to shop, and even how to vote. Peter encourages us not to be holy in some of our conduct, but in all of our conduct. Such intense self-interrogation can only happen through the lens of the Word, consistent prayer, the leading of the Holy Spirit, and the support of the Christian community. Heavenly Father, fill our hearts with what we truly desire, for who we truly seek is You.